Well, hello everyone, and welcome back here to Plants vs. Zombies. We are once again in the backyard dealing with snorkel zombies, and there's going to be zombonies coming as well. So, let's work out a strategy. We shall have that, of course. Our basic weapons, our basic defense, and to add on to that, we'll take the Tangle Kelp. We'll take squash, we will take the cherry bomb. And it's good that jalapeno was... I think I want to take the new item. Let's take some spikeweed. Let's rock. And spikeweed I want to put down towards the end here. And that will help us... Well, first of all, it will soften up zombies as they walk past. But it will also help us very, very much with the zombonies. In fact, I should just kill them. If I understand right, we'll find out, I suppose. So, zombies are coming. Okay, so a few sunflowers out to start off with. He's going to get a take a rake to the face. We don't really have to worry about him just yet. Smack. And, $10, which is very nice. There you go, you can go there, and you can go there. Right. So we've got about half the sunflowers out at the moment that we need at the moment. This is a pretty good start, if you ask me. So, let's get you there. The game's always very gentle at the start, so we don't have to stress about this too much, which is a good thing, really. Okay, but here comes our first serious challenge, so we shall pop that down there and stick a walnut in front of it. Okay, so another one of those. That's our final non-aquatic pea shooter there. In fact, thinking about that, let's start popping down some kelp. Alright, so second pea shooter there because I can't put a walnut there just yet. Alright. And that's our final sunflower. That'll make life a bit easier. We can now put a walnut there, so let's put a walnut there. Start getting some aquatic defenses going. We have three flags this time, so the horde is going to turn up fairly soon. So getting at least some defenses in the water at the start is going to be very important to us. There we go. I think we'll have to use you to deal with that. Thank you very much. I'm tempted to start saving up now for the wave of zombies, and that is exactly what I'm going to do. Let the kelp deal with that guy there. Thank you. Just put another one in his place. That'll do nicely. Right, now we've got plenty of resources to deal with this wave of zombies. See what's going to come. Alright, I was expecting the scuba ones. Other than that, not much. Let's just get some basic defenses out then. Pop you there. Got the kelp. I think we actually want to get some more defenses out in the water as well. Okay. Second row of pea shooters. I think we're going to want to put some walnuts out on the water as well now. So let's go and do that. Stick a kelp down there. Okay. Get a few spikes at the end there. We'll start filling up this area with the spikes now, I think. Put you there. A walnut there. You can see they're getting pretty damaged now just walking over the spikes, which is going to be a great help. Put a set here so that they start taking damage as they're standing by the walnut. Am I missing one? I'm missing one there. Spikes there. It's nice. Okay, one more. We'll have two rows. Okay, coming up the second wave of zombies now. Everything seems to be looking fairly solid at this point. The walnuts are starting to take a bit of a beating, but... oh, it just sounds rude, really, doesn't it? These spikes seem to be helping us a lot with the buckethead zombies. I think it is time to start thinking about replacing some of these walnuts. Let's replace that one. Go! A huge web of zombies is approaching. Okay, let's see how long they last. The answer is not very long. Still surprised we haven't seen the Zomboni, but I suppose they're probably saving that to the last. Okay, yeah. Actually, damage is definitely speeding up the zombie attrition rate. Okay, so. Replace that one when he's finished with it. Looks like we have one more square available to us on the board. Let's get rid of that. There we go. These can later on be enhanced even more. They become metal. I think you've got to buy the recipe in the store. Just waiting for this final horde now. Here we are. Other than that, pretty much done. Let's replace that walnut there. Definitely throwing us into the pool this time. Not throwing us, throwing it into the pool. To no avail, it would seem. I suppose I feel the need to do an explosion. Perhaps just do this. Yeah, that works. Thinking about it now, if that recharges in time, we'll save that for the final wave. But other than that, I think we're ready to go. Which is probably a good thing. A huge wave of zombies is approaching. Right, let's see what happens to the zombie. Oh, as easy as that, was it? Very nice. Destroyed the spikes, but I think we can live with that. Yes, this is turning out to be rather one-sided, isn't it? And I think we are actually going to have a cherry bomb in time. Isn't that nice? Just wait for these guys to get a little bit closer. I think that'll do. And there we are. Torchwood. Peas that pass through it turn into fireballs. Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. I think that is enough for this episode. Next episode, perhaps we'll use this and see how it changes the battlefield. So until then, thank you and good night.